Kinnark is 1908. Supposedly, Wii U released a number of variations on this game in arcades back then, and there were also versions of computers around the same time. Now, it's not surprising that TradeWest released the NES version, since TradeWest and Living was both the same company. As you may have seen, other than John Elway, this is a pretty generic looking football game. We were given teams identified only by the city names, and I'm not really aware of any sort of individual stats for the teams or players. Now, we just recently saw Tecmo Bowl, and this game suffers quite a bit by comparison. The graphics are pretty dull, there is almost no music. The controls sort of like Tecmo Bowl, you choose a play. While controlling the quarterback, you use the D-pad to move around the cursor and select where you want to throw the ball from. However, in order to actually throw the ball, you hit down on the D-pad. It seems like they just could have used one of the buttons to throw the ball instead, that would have made more sense. Though I'll admit, Rare did a pretty good job of seeing three players on the screen at once, at least from a purely technical perspective. Though the action gets pretty confusing, and the players can all sort of coagulate with a bunch of undifferentiated blobs during the plays. Despite the name on the box, John Elway doesn't seem to make any appearance whatsoever in the game. So, it's not really that bad, but pretty unnecessary after Tecmo Bowl. Okay, that's it for US Movie News today. We are now at March 20th, and we've got another FPS game, this time from Team Canada. Oh boy, this looks promising. Hikaru Genji, Roller Panic. Yeah, you heard that right. Roller Panic. Note the copyright to Johnny & Associates there. Hikaru Genji is a very minor game. It's an extremely simple adventure game based on a Japanese boy band. So I guess this game is supposed to be aimed at girls. You need to put your info here. Naturally, blood type is among things you'll have to select. Now pick the dude from the band. Huh, they all look more or less the same. Different hair, I suppose. Aww. Now, Hikaru Genji were a pretty darn popular band for a period of time in the late 80s and early 90s. At one point, they held the top three positions on the Japanese singles charts simultaneously. They were the product of Johnny & Associates, a music talent agency that virtually held a monopoly on Japanese boy bands since the 70s. They were actually run by a guy named Johnny Kitagawa, who was basically the Japanese Lee Pearl, in that he got really rich during their boy bands, which gave him the opportunity to have his way with underage band members. Sorry, I mean, allegedly, at his way. So here are Hikaru Genji, a weird name, I know, since Hikaru Genji is the protagonist of the classic Japanese novel, Hikaru Genji. On the other hand, the character of Hikaru Genji is sort of basically the prototype of the shonen, so maybe the name is sort of appropriate for the band. The band seems to have something like roller skating going on. And the game's plot appears to revolve around the need to find the band's roller skates so the concert can go on. Okay, so you're probably saying, well, this isn't working bad, but